Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm pretty darned excited because YouTube has sent me a little present. Well, they're slowly rolling out this present to all YouTube content creators. It's called video cards, or just cards in the creator studio. What are YouTube cards? I'm glad you asked because they're the topic du jour on Dotto Tech. So YouTube content creators over the next little while will be getting this little new icon in their creator studio in the editing module. So I'm in the editing area for my video, and I've got this opportunity to add something called YouTube cards to my video. Now, what are cards? Well, they're little basic graphics that will slide across in front of our video, and they really open up some new opportunities for us, but they also really up the production quality for YouTube content creators. Let me show you what a card looks like. Now, I've just enabled my very first one on a video that I posted earlier this week. So here's the video. Let me run the video so you can see
how
the cards are
implemented.
There it is. I'm going to pause it right now. Do you see the little graphic here at the very top where it says Screencasting Secrets? What I did was I created a card to promote an upcoming webinar that I'm doing. And it's got this little information, this little I button here as well. Now that I button is persistent through the video, but the Screencasting Secrets pops out when I told it to. Now what happens when I click on that is this little message pops out of the side of the video screen. Now I wasn't able to find specifics on the scaling and the sizing, so I played around a little bit in order to create this video. Now this graphic I created was 400 pixels by 400 pixels. When I created a larger one, it was cut off. So that's the size of graphics that you create. I'll show you how to create the graphic in a moment. But it's basically a call to action, and anything that we could have done previously in an annotation, such as going to an associated website or launching a merchant site or any of those sorts of things, is available to us from here, including subscribing to videos or playing other videos from this screen. Now, the graphic has to be a PNG file, I do believe. I tried to upload it with a JPEG and it would not upload. So I believe they are PNG files. Now I apologize if I'm still kind of working my way through this, but there's not a lot of help notes on the topic yet available on YouTube. So it's kind of a voyage of discovery still. Now this area here at the top, the text here, Screencasting Secrets Webinar, free webinar. This text is user definable. We can actually decide what text we want to put in. And again, I will show you that in a minute. But if I click on this, what will happen is it will then take me to that to whatever URL I have that I have pointed to in that particular graphic, and I've assigned. So then now it's going through and it's loading. It's taking a few seconds, but it's going through and it's going to be loading up a opt-in page for my upcoming webinar. So isn't that cool? So let's take a look. So you've seen now how it looks in action. Let's show you how it looks in editing. So if you find the tool here in the very top menu bar where info settings next to annotations, and it's very similar to annotations, but profoundly different than annotations. Annotations, of course, are wonderful tools where we can actually overlay elements on our video that allow people to click, go to our associated websites, subscribe to our videos, that sort of stuff we can create within annotations, or we can just do titlings. But we're very limited as far as formatting. We can't incorporate new graphics or anything like that. So any graphics that we have to be embedded actually in our video. With cards, we can actually start to bring in some other graphical elements, meaning we can really dress up the presentation of our video. They are similar to annotations, but oh so much more brand friendly. Does that make sense? All I'm going to do here is I'm going to click on, actually, let's add a new card, and I'll walk you through the steps that are involved in creating a card. So you can create a card that's going to point to your associated website, which is part of your account with YouTube, to a fundraising site, to a merchandise, or to a video or playlist within your account. So that's what I'm limited to right now. If I'm going to send it to an associated website, that means that's the site that I've authorized with YouTube. That is my site that I can point back to, and I can put the URL in. So you can start by putting in the URL. So in my case, it's going to point back to dottotech.com. And you can go to any page within your website. Okay. There we go. There it is. So that should be verified now as a page that it will go to. Now, it's going to pull a image from whatever page you're sending it to. Plus, it's also going to pull the name of the page. So what it's doing over here is it's showing the image that it thinks we might want, which is just one of the images that's loaded onto my page, onto the page. And it's also pulling the name of the page. So I'm going to call this something else, because I don't want to call it just Dotto Tech. But so you can actually put the name here of whatever you want. So mine was free webinar that I was promoting. If I'm promoting a free webinar, we can put in our own name here. And then you can also put in a call to action. Now the call to action is going to be what we see in the bottom part of that video. Remember when we looked at the video? And again, I'll show it to you again in a few moments. But we can create a call to action. So it could say something else. They're suggesting, say, visit website, subscribe now, seating is limited. You could put those sorts of things in here. And finally, you can upload your own image. Again, it's limited to a PNG. You can upload an image. And I created graphics in 400 by 400 pixels. It seemed to resolve fine. I think it's going to scale it down to make it fit. But I think you want to be careful of your headroom to make sure that your full message is in. The good thing is you can test it out as you're going along. So I'm going to cancel this because I don't want to create a new card. But here I've got the existing card, which is called Screencasting Secrets. So it's talking about webinar. If we take a look in the editing, it says the call to action says free webinar, and the teaser text is Screencasting Secrets. So the teaser text is what appears here, is what appears in the top when it's playing. So if we take a look back in the video itself, the teaser text is going to be Screencasting Secrets. So let's just close this down and let's take a look at how it resolves again. Because the nomenclature, that what they name each of these elements is something that we have to pay attention to. So here's the graphic going to come in at about 8 seconds. There it is. So the teaser text is what we see here, Screencasting Secrets. So if we look back in the graphic, or we look back in the editor, Screencasting Secrets, that's my teaser text. So let's go back and look at it. If I then click on the eye, what comes out is the URL, Screencasting Secrets webinar, and the blue text, which looks like a link, it says free webinar. Again, we see it here. So free webinar is the call to action, and Screencasting Secrets webinar, this name here, appears in the bottom box right there. So this is going to take some playing with to figure out, but it's so nice to see some nice graph. I mean, if we take a look at the very end, I've got annotations in it in this video. Now, I don't have any text-based annotations, but if we go right to the end, I've got little annotations over top of graphics that I've embedded in it. But it's so nice to have this kind of a color and a design going into our video that we can create ourselves, rather than having to work within the annotations editor, which just limits us to, you know, basically a few web-friendly fonts and a few sizes and no ability to create any graphical treatment to it at all. Now, the other thing that we should be aware of in this is the fact that we can determine here on a timeline when it appears, card appears, and we can have multiple cards in our videos, and they can, as I say, point to websites, they can point to other videos, so it becomes some nice supporting content within our video. Another really nice thing about the cards is we can do time-sensitive content. So you could take and you could build cards, you could build a graphic for a card, and you could quickly add cards to several videos for something like an upcoming webinar. And then when that webinar is over, you could go in and you could remove the cards. Now there is one change to the structure of the video as a result. If we take a look at the video playback here, is down in the bottom right-hand corner, the subscribe button or the channel branding that you can create in your channel has moved from the top right corner to the bottom right corner. So I actually have a subscribe link. You can't see it here right now, but it is there. There is one other quite exciting part of this entire equation, and that's the fact that this is resolving on my iPhone. Now, I tested this on the iPhone. It's on my iPhone 6 Plus. We're in the newest 10, I don't know, OS, the latest operating system for iOS. And I've also tested it on this brand new Samsung Galaxy S6 running Android. The cards did not work on the Android. I could not access them on it. Now, that might just be, it might be something that I'm doing wrong. I tend to think that it's not quite ready for Android yet. Having said that, take a look at the video here. Let me just run this video back, and I'm going to play it on the iPhone for you.
How the heck you doing this?
And it's going to play forward, and there, at the there it is. They in comes this. Now, this is important because annotations don't work. For the most part, on the iPhone. So the ability to be able to now tap on it and bring it out on the iPhone means that we're extending this interactivity in YouTube into mobile really for the first time. So this is a very important step in the evolution of YouTube in mobile delivery, being able to create interactions, calls to action, asking people to sign up for something or visit our website to read the blog, to go for more information. That is an important step forward as far as YouTube content creators are concerned. You can tell I'm a wee bit excited about it. And I know that I'm going to be over the next couple of weeks figuring out all sorts of different kind of creative ways to use this. So I'm quite excited about that. That's enough. I hope that you found today's video to be useful and maybe a little bit entertaining as well. Remember, there's three different ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech, and I'm going to put up some old-fashioned annotations here on the screen. You can subscribe to our newsletter, you can subscribe to our channel itself, and you can also support us on Patreon. Dotto Tech is a crowd-funded site, and we're supported by the community that views us through the crowdfunding site Patreon. If you want to know what perks are involved in supporting Dotto Tech, I encourage you to have a wee gander at our Patreon page. That is it for today. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.